I'm doing, I'm trying to deconstruct, you know, this technology. And as I told you, through, of course, trying some historical documentation, but also, coming back, you know, to my presentation again, to using a semiotic of objects. So I will be, again, I will make a shorter, a long history, but basically the idea is to study the politics of digital visualization of the European space of education by the use of semiotics. So this is you know, a summary, because one of the points that I would like to stress is it is very difficult to study this digital technology. As I told you before, they are made of code, algorithm, they are complex assemblage. One of the problems that I had when I studied these elements, for example, is to come in contact with the designer, you know, of these digital things, because mostly they are completely unknown. Again, in studying algorithm, there is other methodological problems because of the nature of the making of algorithms. Sometimes, even if you come in contact with a company, this, you know, private company has many branches, you know, everywhere in the world. So you don't know exactly who are, you know, exactly the producer of a piece of an algorithm, and maybe they don't know exactly about where a line of codes will be put in a big sets of instructions. So it is very difficult. They are not simple objects to study and to deconstruct. So there are methodological problems, you know, in studying the digital governance, because even if you can say, okay, it's all about privatization, this could be, you know, a conclusion that you can come. But you miss some points. You miss the work of production. It involves sometimes not just, you know, private company, but complex collaboration between private and public sector. For example, in the case of Italy, the platform Scuola in Chiaro, of course, was currently done by multinational companies, but there is a collaboration with the ministry. So, so there is a sort of you know, heterarchies, you know, a connection between the private and so. And if you don't consider this, it's not just you know, an element of which is of course there is also an increasing role of this kind of companies in this making, but it's not. It is only one element of this very complex assemblage. So basically, I'm going to finish on this. On the semiotic of objects, I found very useful this methodology was basically made by relying on actor network theory. It was extended by this colleague in Bolzano, which is Alvise Mattozzi. I don't know if Martino knows, but he's a STS scholar and is you know, studies of science and technologies, you know, and this is the, and he did a methodology quite interesting, you know, to study any kind of objects that can be virtual, that can be physical objects, and so far and so on. And he says that basically you can deconstruct, you know, the semiotics of an object by looking at three elements. If you look at an object as a singular object, as objects in interaction with other objects, as an object, an artifact, thinking about, you know, this digital technology that we are talking about before, in use. So, just to give if you look at an object as a singularity, of course, you can look at what he says, the plastic configuration of object, the body, and the figurative element. Let's just give you an example, because otherwise it will be very abstract. Let's do the semiotics of these bottles, you know, this bottle of waters. Basically, what you see in terms of an object, the singularity, it has a border. But if you look at the plastic configuration, think about it as an object of art, for contemporary art. What you see? You see forms, you see colors, you see lines, you see shapes. So this is a one element, you know, to study, you know, an object. Another element is that an object has a body. It means that it has a core and an envelope. And of course, thinking about this bottle, it has, of course, a surface, and it has a content, which is a liquid, of course. And that is basically the way you can look at the digital platform. You can go to the web page and see it as it was a contemporary drawing. See? What you see? You see colors, you see form, you basically see the aesthetics of the digital things. But you know, these digital things that are also in frames. You know, meaning that have boxes that include and excludes, and you can see the contrast, you can see the images. And of course, looking at the bottle, it has a figurative element, means that it has a nameable and recognizable part. It means that it has a cup, no, a neck. You know, you can see that they are made of many parts. You can see how an object is not just an object, but it is a network. It is already a network of elements. So it has a singularity, but at the same time, it has also interconnection between the elements of these objects. Similarly, if you look at the website or any digital formation, any digital things, you can see how it is made of several parts together, you know, many elements, many items. It has an headline, it has a body, it has a footnote, it has an address, and so far and so on. So this is a way to understand how the designer do in order to do a website. Another way of thinking, analyzing this object is to look at the scripts. You know, what you can do, what are the program of action of this battle, according to you? It means that it is you can consider this bottle as a proposition. Let's say, look at the bottle. They have a form. Why they have a form? Because it has a script inside this form. It invites you, because it is a big plastic bottle, so it has a sort of handle. It invites you to take, you know, the bottle in the middle and not, you know, in the bottom. You know, you can see that the shape, it invites you to take the bottle, you know, in a particular way, to grasp the bottle in a particular way. Similarly, in the case of a digital things, it invites you to do some operations, for example. In the case of the Google page, what you see? A frame, and so you are invited to write. And you write inside. So you can see the kind of analysis that I am inviting you to do with these digital things, you know, to deconstruct it, to see what are the decisions the designer made. It's important to see that sometimes these objects are made of intention that are even not, they are not in the of the sense of the designer sometimes. They can do things that even the designer do not understand completely. So it's an invitation to see what are the scripts, the program of action, what you can do, in other words, with these digital things. It is a search engine, so you can do search schools. You can have data. So that's, you know, the several scripts that are inscribed in these digital things. So it is an invitation to look at how these algorithms. And of course, the latest elements of this analysis was an invitation to look at how the digital technology works with other objects in practice. How it is used, you know, in practice? How the European, firstly, who use it? What is the audience? Why these digital things has been taken, you know, in practice? For what purpose? So with what other technologies? So it's an object in use. So you can see how, you know, actor network theory and this kind of semiotic analysis invites you to do research on these digital technologies.